Praise the Lord, everybody, and welcome to True Light Church of God in Christ. Amen. We're here to magnify and bless the name of the Lord. For I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Amen. We're a little late getting started. We had some technical difficulties. Amen. But that's all right. We're come to magnify God. Amen. And as we continue to worship together, amen, I promise God's going to meet us here in our parking lot. Amen. Those that are watching live stream, amen, we want to welcome you. Amen. Get involved on this morning as we give God glory, as we give him praise. Amen. Come on, do me a favor right where you are and just begin to clap your hands. Amen. Honk your horns. Amen. Let's give God praise on this morning. Amen. For he's worthy to be praised. Come on, come on, come on. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Come on, give God a praise in this place. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Amen. We thank God, amen, for you joining us. Amen, amen. And we're just looking forward to this awesome service. Amen. Amen. We're looking forward to God blessing us on this morning. I don't know about you. Amen. But I'm looking to leave differently. Amen. I don't want to leave the same way that I came on this morning. Amen. I'm looking for God to meet needs. I'm looking for God to heal. I'm looking for God to have his way on this morning. Amen. Amen. Is there anybody in the house this morning or in the parking lot? Amen. That's looking to leave differently. Amen. Looking for a blessing. Looking for a miracle. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. My soul loves Jesus. My soul loves Jesus. My soul love him on this morning. My soul loves Jesus. My soul loves Jesus. Bless his name. My soul loves Jesus, my soul loves Jesus, my soul. This morning, yes, 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 Lord. Come on, say yes to him, Zion. Yes, Lord. God, in the name of Jesus, we count it an honor and privilege to be back into your presence on this morning. God, we've come to worship you on this morning. We've come to magnify your name. We've come to glorify your name on this morning. God, we are asking you on this morning to have your way like never before, God. Oh, God, move through the midst of this service. Move through the parking lot. Move on the live stream, God. Oh, God, have your way like never before, oh, God. We count it an honor and a privilege to be in your presence on this morning. Your word tells us that when two or three are gathered in your name, there you are in the midst. And God, we feel you in the midst this on this morning. God, we're just asking you, oh God, to meet needs on this morning. God, we're asking you, oh God, to set the captive free on this morning. God, heal bodies on this morning. Do what you want to do, God. We move out the way, oh God. We move out the way so that way you can have your way. God, we decrease that you may increase. God, we're asking you on this morning, oh God, just to, oh God, move like never before, God. Oh God, do what you want to do, God. We move the program out the way, oh God, and we allow you to have your way, God. Oh God, do what you want to do on this morning. Prick the hearts of the listener, God. Lord, those that are out on the parking lot this morning, touch them in a mighty way, God. Oh God, we ask you to meet their needs, God. Oh God, do what you want to do with them, God. Those that are watching on the live stream, God. Lord, do what you want to do. God, we want, oh God, to leave differently today, God. We want to leave changed today, God. Oh God, we want to leave feeling better on today, God. So God, we just ask you, God, to have your way, God. Move through the midst of this service, God. Move through the praise and worship. Move through the giving, oh God. Move through the preach word on today, God. Move, 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 oh God, in the name of Jesus. And if you do all these things, we'll be careful to give your name all the glory, honor, and praise. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen, amen, amen. Listen, our praise and worship is getting ready to come. Our first lady, amen, she's going to come with praise and worship, amen. But I want to take a second and give honor on this morning, amen, to a great man of God, amen. We're here to worship God, but we're also going to celebrate this man of God for his birthday, amen. Do me a favor, make some noise, honk some horns, amen, for the superintendent, Pastor Emeritus Jerome L. Walker Sr. Come on, come on, come on, celebrate him. Celebrate him! Celebrate him! Hallelujah! Awesome man of God. A man of integrity. Amen, amen. And through our service today, we're going to celebrate him. Amen. We're going to hear from him very soon. Amen. But we're going to ask our first lady to come with a few songs of praise and worship. Listen, get involved. I know it's a little hot out here. Amen. But can I tell you something? If you don't plan on going to hell, amen, you might as well enjoy this heat, because hell is hotter. Amen. Amen. So let's worship him. Amen. I promise you, if you clap your hands and give God praise, a cool breeze will come on this parking lot. Amen. Because he said he inhabit the praises of his people. Amen. So let's celebrate. Amen. Let's honor God. Let's bless him. Amen. Let's praise him with the fruit of our lips. As she sings, clap your hands. Amen. And get involved with the service on this morning. Let's say amen for our first lady.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How many came to have church on this morning? How many came to have church on this morning?
Yeah.
back with a glorious day.
Oh, he's coming back.
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 Will you be ready?
He's coming back.
Will you be ready?
He's coming back.
Will you be ready?
He's coming back.
Thank you.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, amen. I don't know about you, but I thank him all the time. Amen, because it could have been another way. Amen, it could have been another way. It could have been another way. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen, we thank you all for joining us here, amen, at the True Light Church of God in Christ. We thank you for those that are in the parking lot, those that are joining us live stream, amen. And we're just glad to be here once again, amen. It's been a few Sundays since we've been in the parking lot, amen, but we're glad to be back on this morning, amen. We're glad to be back on this morning, amen. And we're excited about the various things that we have to talk about and do on this morning, amen. We thank God, amen. We see Sister Beth is back with us, amen. It's good to see you, Sister Beth. Amen. Sister Beth is one of the nurses that was sent to New York City, amen, to work during the pandemic. Amen. And we're glad that God brought her back home safe. Amen, amen. God brought her back home safe. Amen, amen. So we're glad to see her this morning. Amen. We want to remind you of our ways of giving, amen, your tithes and offering on this morning. You can definitely give by way of electronic giving, amen. You can give by way of Givelify, amen. You can search us on Givelify, True Light, Church of God in Christ, amen. You also can give by way of Cash App, TLC, OGIC 362, amen. And we also, on the way out, will have a basket, amen, where you can sow your gifts. Amen. If you desire, you can sow your gifts that you have today. Amen. Cash or check. We're right now doing our best to continue to provide a touchless experience. So we're not right now accepting credit or debit card. Amen. But we encourage you to give. Amen. The Bible tells us he loves a cheerful giver. Amen. Amen. He loves a cheerful giver. So we want to encourage you to give. Amen. During this season. Amen. We also want you to join us this week on the prayer line. Amen. Join us on the prayer line. We have a couple of different things that we're going to be doing and starting this week. Amen. And we're excited about those. Amen. So join us this Sunday or this Monday, tomorrow on the prayer line, and we'll be able to explain everything that we're going to be doing this week. Amen. We have some great things in store for you. Amen. Join us Thursday for our Bible study, 6:30. Prayer, 7:30 Bible study on Thursday on the conference line. Amen. And continue to join us for Sunday school. Amen. Sunday school has been going strong every Sunday, 9:45. We thank God for our church mother and our Sunday school superintendent being with us, Mother Jewel Walker. Amen. It's good to see you, Mother. Amen. It's good to see you. Amen. So definitely meet us for Sunday school. Amen. And I want to, if I can, meet with all of the men immediately following service today. If I can meet with the men's department immediately following service, there's a couple things that we need to discuss. Amen. So all the men that belong to True Light, if you're here in the parking lot, meet with me immediately following service. There's a couple things that I want to talk about with you before we leave this evening or this afternoon. Amen. And next Sunday, somebody shout next Sunday. Somebody shout next Sunday. Amen. Next Sunday, amen, we will not be in our parking lot, amen, but we will be joining in fellowshipping next week with Faith, Hope, and Charity Worship Center. Amen. If many of you remember, one of the leaders there, Bishop Crocker, came and spoke for Father's Day here. Amen. And next Sunday, they've invited me, your pastor, amen, to go and speak at Faith, Hope, and Charity. So we want to invite everyone from True Light to come with us. Amen. They're down the street on the other end of Columbia towards Plymouth. Amen. You can meet us there. Their service starts at 11, just like ours. Amen. So join us next week, Faith, Hope, and Charity, at Faith, Hope, and Charity Worship Center for their parking lot service. Amen. Our media team will be going, so we will be going live there as well. So if you cannot make the physical service, amen, you can watch live at the True Light Church of God in Christ Facebook page. We will be live there, amen, and we'll be fellowshipping with them. Two churches coming together, amen, to fellowship together, amen. I'm gonna tell you something. It's not about just individual churches, but it's about the entire body of Christ fellowshipping together. Amen. I often say, how can you plan to go to heaven and share heaven with somebody if you can't share earth with them? Amen. So we ought to go down to them, amen, and worship with them, amen, and fellowship with them, amen. Faith, Hope, and Charity Worship Center. Amen. So join us there on Sunday. This upcoming Sunday service begins at 11 o'clock. Now, I will tell you, there is limited parking, so we do want you to, if you plan on attending, plan to arrive early. Amen. The van will also be going. So if you want to carpool, you can park here. Amen. And ride the van, but definitely get in touch with Deacon Kelly ahead of time. Amen. So that way he can plan accordingly. Amen. Those are our announcements. Please govern yourselves accordingly. Amen. Amen. We celebrated our graduates. Amen. A few Sundays ago, we celebrated our graduates, and we have one more graduate. Amen. She ended up getting her information a little after we celebrated our graduates. So we want to celebrate her. Amen. For her achievement. She's part of the class of 2020. Amen. So we're going to ask if Sister Toni Butler can come at this time. Come on, let's celebrate her as she comes. Amen. Come on, y'all can do better than that. Honk those horns. Amen. Amen. Sister Toni Butler graduated from the Home Health Aid Certification Department at Rochester, SUNY Brockport, R-E-O-C. Amen. And she graduated. Amen. So we want to celebrate her. Amen. For her achievement. Amen. Although we celebrated other graduates, we wanted to make sure we gave her honor. Amen. For graduating. So let's celebrate Sister Toni Butler one more time. Amen. We're proud of you. God bless you. Amen. 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 We love you. Amen. 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 That's all right. Amen. That's all right. Amen. The enemy tries to come in and kick up how he can. Amen. But we still got the victory. Somebody shout, we got the victory. We got the victory. Amen. Amen. Today's a special day. Amen. Although it's not his actual birthday. His actual birthday is on Tuesday. Amen. But with this being our Sunday morning service, we want to celebrate this awesome man of God. Amen. He's the founder of True Light Church of God in Christ. Amen. He, in January, decided to retire and become pastor emeritus. Amen. And found enough trust in me to take over his legacy. Amen. And keep the vision going. Amen. Amen. And with his birthday being in July, amen, we want to start this. Amen. Amen. We want to this be the first, amen, of many. Amen. This will be the first of many. Amen. We want to celebrate his birthday and kind of make it a Founders Day celebration. Amen. If we were in the sanctuary, amen, we would schedule to have dinner. Amen. 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 If we were in our sanctuary and able to, we would have dinner. Amen. And invite some of his long friends, amen, and other people in the ministry, amen, that has watched him grow in ministry and as he continued to do God's will with True Light, amen. But as I stated, this will be one of many, amen, that we will honor and celebrate this great man. He's a man of integrity. He's a man of wisdom, amen. I'm gonna tell you something. He's done so much for this community and so much for people in this community. Amen. He's done so much for Church of God in Christ. Amen. At large, the jurisdiction. Amen. He's not only Pastor Emeritus of True Light. Amen. He's also superintendent. He's the superintendent of District 5. Amen. Amen. And we want to celebrate him. Amen. We're going to ask for him and his lovely wife, Evangelist Walker. Amen. To come on out the car. Amen. And we're going to ask Deacon Kelly. Amen. To bring what we have for him. Amen. Many of you have brought your cards and love tokens, amen, and have put it in the box, amen. And we want to just be a blessing to him, amen, for being such an awesome, amen, man, to many of us, amen, a mentor to many of us, amen, just an inspiration, amen. So we want to celebrate Superintendent Jerome L. Walker Sr., amen. Amen, amen. Amen. At this time, we're going to hear words from him on this afternoon.
Now, let's give the Lord a hand, praise. Tell him thank you. Come on, let's give God a hand. Oh, what a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Truly, it's a blessing to be here on today. Amen. And it's a blessing to just be among the saints of God. Amen. We serve a good God. Serve a powerful God, and it's just a blessing to be here once again. We're certainly happy for Pastor Alexander and his companion. Amen. And certainly happy for all of you that's here on today. Celebrate this great day. All days are great. And we're celebrating and giving our God the praise and glory and the honor. Thanking the Lord for each and everyone here. Amen. Certainly happy for my beautiful wife. Yes. Amen. She's the, some say the better part. But thank God for her. Amen. Thank God for marriages overall. God is a good God, is he not?
Yes,
Lord. Amen. Amen. Thank God for salvation. Thank him for waking us up this morning with a mind that want to serve him still. Those were some powerful words coming from Pastor Alexander. Amen. This year, pandemic is still here. And there are a lot of people that's going on in, going home. Amen. Whichever way they decided to go. But we are still here. We're yet able to give him praise. We're yet able to give him glory. We're yet able to give him honor. Amen. And he woke us up this morning, started us on our way. And here we are. Amen. And I'll tell you, it's just good to be saved. Amen. Sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost. Amen. And serving the Most High God. Thanking him for giving me another chance and my wife. Amen. Praise God. We could have been gone in, but we're still here. And by being here, he yet has a work for us to do. Praise God. Praise God. Tell you, it's just wonderful to be in the number. Are you glad you're in the number today? Oh, bless the wonderful name of Jesus. It's good to be saved. Amen. I wasn't always saved, praise God, but I'm so glad that one day I made mine up and I did some godly sorrowing and some repenting. Amen. And I said, yes, Lord. Praise God. One of the better moves I ever made in my life. Hallelujah to God. God called us into the ministry. Amen. And it's just been wonderful. Been wonderful. There's nothing like being a servant of the Most High God. And church, let me tell you, it's good to be on the prayer line. It's good to be prayerful. It's good to just give your life to the Lord. Amen. It's good, even better at a young age. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Well, praise God. We're living in perilous times. Perilous times is here. Well, praise God. We're witnesses to something that's never happened. Amen. We're really witnessing something that's never happened. Amen. Here in these United States. Praise God. Amen. In our lifetime, praise God. And God is yet blessing. He's still blessing. He's in control of this here virus. Amen. When he get ready for it to be over, it's going to be over, and that's it. And I can stand here and say people are giving their life to the Lord during this time. Oh, yes. During this time. People are saying, yes, Lord. Hallelujah to God. You see? Amen. And it does my heart good to see them coming. And as I first stated, I wasn't always saved, but thank God I'm saved today.
Amen.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. And I want to thank everyone for being here on today. Amen. This is a day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad at it. So glad that he gave me time and to get my life together. Amen. Another year with the Lord, and here I am, my wife and I. And she going to have a few words in this time. Praise God. Let's say amen for her.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise God. We're just so blessed and so happy for my husband to be able to celebrate another year. And I'll say another year with Jesus. And we thank God for all of you, and you all continue to pray for us. God bless you.
Amen, amen. Amen. We thank God for both of them. Amen. And we have here, Superintendent, we want to present to you, amen, this box, amen, that has different love tokens and words of encouragement and cards that the saints have put together and put in there for you. Amen. And we hope that you enjoy your day on this upcoming 22nd, July 22nd. Amen. So we love you and we appreciate you. Amen. 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 Can y'all join me with singing happy birthday to him? One, two, three.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday,
dear. Happy birthday to you. Amen. Amen. We also want to say happy birthday, amen, to Mother Butler, amen, who celebrated her birthday on this past Friday. Amen. Mother Butler, we love you. Amen. 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 And Brother Jamal. Both same day? All right, Brother Jordan was on the 16th and Brother Jamal was on the 8th. Amen. We thank God for them. Amen. All the July birthdays. Amen. Amen. All of the July birthdays. Amen. Amen. At this time, we're going to get ready for the word. Amen. Right before we come with the word of God. Amen. We're going to have our dancers come. Amen. The God-appointed praisers are coming forth. Amen. And they're going to minister in dance. Amen. And then following that, we'll come with the word of God. Let's say amen for them as they come. Come on, let's give him a praise. Amen. If he's brought you over mountains, come on, give him praise. If he's brought you over tests and trials, give him praise. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, let's clap our hands again for God appointed praisers. Amen. We had a little technical difficulties, but that's all right. Amen. God still gets the glory. God still gets the praise. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you. We praise you for this service thus far. God, we ask you, oh God, to speak through these lips of clay. I decrease that you may increase. Have your way, God. Speak to me, God, Lord, that I may say something that will bless the people, oh God, Lord, that will edify the people, that will lift them up. In the mighty name of Jesus, oh God, we just thank you for your presence, amen. And we just ask you, oh God, to move like never before. In Jesus' mighty name we pray, amen, amen, amen. Amen. I want to read a passage of scripture from the Gospel of Luke. Amen, Luke. Start at verse 1. It says, now when he had ended all this saying in the audience of the people, he entered into Capernaum. And a certain centurion servant who was dead unto him and was sick, was dear unto him and was sick and ready to die. And a certain centurion servant who was dear unto him was sick and ready to die. And when he heard of Jesus, he sent unto him the elders of the Jews, beseeching him that he would come and heal his servant. And when they came to Jesus, they besought him instantly, saying that he was worthy for him he should do this. For he loveth our nation and hath built us a synagogue. Verse 6 says, then Jesus went with them, and when he was now not far from the house, the centurion sent friends to him, saying unto him, Lord, trouble not thyself, for I am not worthy that thou shalt enter unto my roof. Under my roof. Wherefore neither thought I myself worthy to come unto thee, but say in a word, and my servant shall be healed. Wherefore neither thought I myself worthy to come unto thee, but say in a word, and my servant shall be healed. For I also am a man set under authority, having under my soldiers. And I say unto one, go, and he goeth, and to another, come, and he cometh, and to my servant, do this, and he doeth. Amen. I want to go back up to Luke 7:7. It says, wherefore neither thought I myself worthy to come unto thee, but say in a word, and my servant shall be healed. In this text, we find that there was a centurion man who had a servant who was sick of palsy. Amen. He was sick and was going to die. Amen. And this centurion sent out his men to go to Jesus because he heard of Jesus. Amen. And when he heard of Jesus, he sent them out. Amen. And he told them that, tell them that I have a servant that needs to be healed. And Jesus told him, well, I'll come to his house and heal him. And the servant said, no, I'm not worthy enough for you to be able to come under my roof. Amen. But if you just send the word, amen, my servant will be healed. I want to talk, amen, on this topic, amen. I just want to talk on this four-word topic. It says, just say the word. Just say the word. Somebody repeat that with me. Say, just say the word. Amen, my brothers and sisters, in times like these, we are in need of a word. Amen, a word that will lift us up, a word that will encourage us, a word that will help us in this season, a word that will strengthen us. Amen. Don't get me wrong, I love praise and worship. I love the dancing and the praising of God. I love when we fellowship. I love when the girls dance. I love the fellowship of the service. Amen, the different aspects of the service. But can I tell you something? The most important part of the service, amen, is the word of God. God bless you, Brother Barley. Good to see you again. Amen. It's so important, amen. The word of God is so important because it's the word, amen, that will sustain you. It's the word that will keep us, amen. Praise and worship won't keep us, amen. Praise and worship won't, praise and worship will usher in the presence of God. Praise and worship will get us in the mindset, amen, to receive the word of God. But the most important part of the service is the word of God, because it's the word, amen, that will lift us up. It's the word, amen, that does what we need it to do, amen. We cannot live in this Christian walk. We can't walk on this Christian journey, amen, without the word of God. It's so important, amen, that we have a word from God. I was looking on Facebook, amen, and there was a study that was done. There was a group of college students, amen, that begin to put together two greenhouses, amen. If you know about greenhouses, it's these houses that they build, amen, to grow plants and grow different things in the greenhouse, amen. And oftentimes they do studies from what they're growing in this greenhouse. But these college students, amen, that went to a Christian college, they built two greenhouses behind the college. And what they begin to do is they built these greenhouses the same way. They had the same they had the same air conditioning. They had the same different compartments, amen. They were built identical. It was two greenhouses that were built identical. They put the same type of plants in these greenhouses. They watered them the same. They gave them the same type of food. They did everything identical for these two greenhouses, but one thing. What they begin to do as they went to go and water the greenhouse, as they begin to water the plants that was in the greenhouse, one particular part of the students, amen, they would go to the greenhouse, and when they were watering them, they would speak positive things. They would tell the plants to grow. They would tell the plants that they are going to be great. They would tell the plants, amen, all great things. They were speaking positive over the plants. But the other group of kids, when they went and watered the other greenhouse, when they were in there, they would speak negative over the plants. They would talk negative to the plants, tell them they weren't worth anything, that they won't grow. Amen. And after weeks and weeks of doing the same thing over and over again, what the study showed was the plants that were in the greenhouse that they spoke positive over, those plants were living. But shortly after, amen, they begin to realize that the plants that were in the other greenhouse where they spoke negative over, those plants would not grow. Those plants did not grow well. And what are you trying to say, Pastor Alexander? I'm telling you that no matter what you speak, amen, if you're speaking positive, it will help somebody grow. If you speak positive over people's lives, it would help them grow. But if you speak negative over people's lives, it does nothing but tear people down. Amen. If this can be done with some plants, what do you think can be done with us as human beings? That's why it's very important, amen, that I speak positive over people, amen. Oh, no matter how you do me wrong, amen, no matter how I might personally feel about you, it's very important that I speak positive over your life. It's very important for me to tell you that you're fearfully and wonderfully made of God. It's very important that I tell you that you're beautiful in the eyesight of God. It's very important that I tell you that you shall live and not die. It's very important for me to tell you that cancer won't take you out. It's important for me to tell you that high blood pressure won't take you out. But I gotta let your pastor speak into your life and tell you that you shall live and not die. Yeah, you ain't gotta stay strung out on dope. You ain't gotta stick to that alcohol bottle. You ain't gotta let that man tell you that you're no good, because you're fearfully and made of God. You're beautiful in the eyesight of God. Don't belittle yourself and let nobody tell you that you're good for nothing. But tell yourself, I am the head and not the tail. I'm above only and not beneath. I'm made by God. It's very important that you speak positive over people's lives. It's very important that you speak positive over yourself, because people don't realize, amen, that life and death is in the power of the tongue. Your words carry weight. Your words carry power. Amen. And if you really look at this, study that was being done, it was so amazing. Amen. It was so amazing to me that in the midst of plants
the plants were able to see, amen, that the words have power. Amen. It was very interesting that the plants, they spoke over the plants and the plants begin to live. Amen. That's why it's important, amen, for us to recognize as believers that our words have power. That's why it's important for us to protect our ear gates. Amen. It's very important, amen, that you don't allow people to speak negativity in your life. Listen, don't come around me speaking into my life unless you're going to speak life, unless you're going to speak health, unless you're going to speak prosperity, unless you're speaking the word of God. Amen. Look at somebody and say, I just need you to speak the word. Listen, don't come to me talking no foolishness, but come speaking the word. I need you to speak the word into my life. I don't need you to speak what you feel. I don't need you to speak your opinions. I don't want you to speak what you think about the situation. But when I come to you and talk to you, I need you to tell me the word of God. Don't tell me what you think should happen. Don't tell me what you thought should happen. Don't tell me how you feel or what your opinion is. But speak the word of God. The word of God is sharper than any two-edged sword. I need you to speak the word of God in my life. When I come to you about my situation, when I come to you about my circumstance, when people go to people, amen, I want to tell you, encourage you, speak the word and only the word. Don't talk about what you feel. Don't talk about how you think it should go, but just speak the word. Or look at somebody and say, I need you to just speak the word. Just speak the word. Tell me the word of God. Tell me the word of God. That's why the Bible tells us, let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich. Let the sick say, I am well. Because, listen, no matter what the situation is, no matter what the outcome look like it's going to be, you have the power to change it by just saying a word. Oh, listen, the doctor may say one thing, but you have the power to change the outcome by just saying the word. Listen, your marriage might look like it's jacked up and all tore up, but you have the power to change it by just saying the word. All you got to do is put the word on it. Just put the word on your circumstance. Put the word on your situation. Put the word on what you're going through. I came to tell somebody on today that came brokenhearted, came with the head hung down, came depressed and broke down. I came to tell you that you can change your outcome by just saying the word. The word, the word, the word. Or somebody tap on themselves and say the word, the word, the word. Just say the word. All you need is the word. In this season, you don't need nothing else but the word of God. That's why the Bible tells us faith comes by hearing, and hearing the word of God. Listen, can I tell you what the word will do? I got five points, and then we're going ready to go. The word will feed you. This is what the word will do. Am I right, superintendent? The word will feed you. That's why Peter 2:2 says, as a newborn longs for the milk, we long for the word of God in order that we may grow in our salvation. The word to feed you. But just recently we had to transition Izzy from milk only and baby food only to solids only, because we wanted to see his growth change. We wanted to see his growth change. Listen, when you become a new member into the body of Christ, when you become a child of God, when you first get saved, amen, the word of God will serve like milk, amen. But the same way, am I talking right, Missionary Bali? The same way that a baby grows in stages and no longer needs milk, amen, we then begin, we then need to look at the word of God as being the bread of life. That's why the Bible says in Mark 4, it is written, man shall not live on bread alone, by every word that proceeds through the mouth of God. Listen, when you first become saved, yes, the word of God is like milk. Amen. But after a while, you shall desire the bread of God, the bread of life. After a while, you begin to desire some more from God. And as you begin to walk through your Christian journey, there will be times where you hunger after the word of God. There will be times that you hunger after God like like never before. There will become times where you're hungry after God, and you'll find yourself going into your prayer closet, and you begin to spend more time with God because you're longing for God's presence. You're longing for God's presence, and you're longing after the Word of God, because the Word of God will, point number one, feed you. But not only will the Word of God feed you, but the Word of God will convict you. Some folks don't like to talk about this word, amen, but the Word of God, it will convict you. That's why Titus 1 tells us, holding to the faithful word according to the teaching, that he may be able to both encourage us with sound teaching and to convict those that contradict it. Amen. Listen, the Word of God will encourage you. Amen. But the Word of God will convict you. Amen. You know, in the late night hour when you shouldn't be where you should be, yeah, that's conviction. That's the Word of God that's on the inside telling you to get away from that person, telling you to get out that bed that ain't your husband's bed. That's when God will convict you. When you in the nightclub, amen, that conviction will take over you. When you not doing right by God, help me in this house, the Word of God will convict you. That's why the Bible tells us to hide the Word in our heart, that we might not sin against God, because we got to recognize, amen, that the Word of God will convict us. But not only will the Word of God convict us, it will challenge us to change. Yes, the Word of God will feed you, the Word of God will convict you, and the Word of God will challenge you to change. That's why the Bible tells us faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. Amen. Because what the Word of God will do as you begin to hear it, it will point out areas that you need to change, and it will challenge you to change. That's why in the midnight hour, amen, when you're doing things that you should not be doing, God will convict your heart, and then it will challenge you to change. It'll tell you that you know better. It will tell you that you were taught better. It will tell you, amen, that you know what God expects of you, and God will challenge you to change. The Bible, the Word of God will feed you. The Word of God will convict you. The Word of God will challenge you to change. Amen. But then the Word of God will produce change. The Word of God will produce change. Amen. God, the Word of God will produce change. If you look in the New Testament, all throughout the New Testament, we see, amen, where God causes Jesus to produce change. There were several times that Jesus walked on the scene, and it seems like somebody needed healing, somebody needed delivering. Amen. But what did Jesus do? By the time Jesus got there, amen, by the time Jesus left, amen, there was change that was produced. And that's what the Word of God will do. It will produce change in your life. It will produce change in your situation. It will produce change in your circumstance. It will produce change in your life. It will produce change in your family's lives. It will produce change in your children's lives. The Word of God will produce change. But my last point on this morning is the Bible, the Word of God, it will equip and complete you. That's why 2 Timothy 3:16 tells us that all scripture is God-breathed and profitable for teaching, conviction, correction, and instruction in righteousness, that the man of God may be completely and fully equipped for the good work of God. And I came to tell somebody that when you get in the Word of God, when you get in the Word of God, it will cause you to be fed. When you get in the Word of God, it will convict you. When you get in the Word of God, it will challenge you to change. When you get in the Word of God, it will produce change. And lastly, when you get in the Word of God, it will equip and complete you. You've been wondering why your life feels like it's not complete. You've been wondering why you feel like you have voids in your life. It's because you're not in the Word of God. But when you get in the Word of God, oh, I feel my help on this morning. When you get in the Word of God, you'll be equipped to go to and fro. You'll be equipped to go into the byways and byways, compelling them to come. When you get in the Word of God, when situations come, amen, when situations come, amen, you'll have a way out, amen, because you remind yourself that many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord will deliver them out of them all. When you're in the Word of God, when tribulation comes, when situations come, you'll remember that we have the victory, because may in all these things, We are more than the conquerors. I gotta get out of here, amen. But when we look in our text on this morning, we see a centurion man who had a servant that was sick. This servant was getting ready to die, and he heard about Jesus. Can I tell you something? When you have an encounter with Jesus, when you have an encounter with Jesus, it's hard for us not to be talking about him. When you have an encounter with Jesus, it's hard for you not to talk about his good works. That's why I can't stand for somebody to tell me that you're always talking about Jesus. I'm always talking about Jesus because I had an encounter with him. And listen, if somebody's bothered about you talking about Jesus, that means they need to get to know him for himself. Because I tell you something on this morning, when I had an encounter with Jesus, my whole life began to change. When I had an encounter with Jesus, my whole thinking began to change. When I had an encounter with Jesus, my whole character began to change. He heard about Jesus, and he knew that Jesus would be able to heal his servant. Now look at this real quick. Listen.
This is why I can't take, amen, when people say it don't take all of that in church. I can't take that because how is it that you want me to go to a football game or a basketball game and show up and make noise for a team that's not paying my bills, that did not save my soul, did not save my marriage, did not save my thinking, did not save me when I was sinking in sin? Listen, how is it that you want me to show out at a basketball game or a football game? How you doing, Sister Walker? Good to see you. How you want me to show out there? Amen. But I can't come to church and show out for the man that saved my soul, that picked me up out of sin, that saved my soul, saved my family, Lord, provided every one of my needs. When I come to church, I'ma show out for Jesus. I'ma show out for Jesus. Listen, I'ma make more noise than I would at the basketball game. Cause when I think about the goodness of Jesus, I wish I had some saints on this morning. When I think about the goodness of Jesus and all that he's done for me, my soul cries out, hallelujah. When I think about how he saved my soul, how he looked past my fault and saw my need, when I begin to think about what Jesus did, I can't help but lift my hands. I can't help but stomp my feet. I can't help but to dance my dance, because he's been too good to me. Has he been good to anybody in the parking lot? Well, do me a favor and take 10 seconds and make some noise for Jesus. Give God. I'm sorry, y'all. I'm sweating on my clothes. Amen. But can I tell you something? When I think about where God brought me from, I can't go to the basketball court and make more noise there than I make when I come to the house of God. Can I get about 10 folk that would just give God a dance right there? Go ahead, give him a dance, give him a dance, give him a dance. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Shabazz over there in that green. Wave your hand, Shabazz. Listen, last week they called me and told me he was in a car accident. And they sent me the picture of the car. And from the picture, it looked like the car was destroyed. But y'all see him standing right there without a scratch or a bruise. And y'all don't want me to give God praise. I could have been playing in his funeral. But here he is in the house of God. I gotta close, but in Luke chapter 2, we see the centurion man. He says, my servant is sick. My servant is getting ready to die. And Jesus replies and tells him, well, I'll come to the house and I'll heal him. But the centurion man says, no, I'm not worthy of you to come under my roof. But if you just say the word. He says, Jesus, you don't gotta come lay hands on him. Jesus, you ain't gotta come lay hands on him. Jesus, you ain't even gotta come in the proximity of my home. Jesus, I got enough faith that if you just say the word. Missionary Kelly, he ain't gotta come lay hands on you. He ain't gotta come lay hands on your children. All he gotta do is say the word.
Yeah.
the name of Jesus, lift your hands. God, we pray a special blessing over each and every person that's watching live. We pray a special blessing over each and every person that's in the parking lot. God, as we speak your word, we know things are changing. As we speak your word, we know circumstances are changing. As we speak your word, we're looking for miracles, signs, and wonders. God, do it right now by your power, for your glory, in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, we know that your word has power. Your word has power. Your word has power. So God, we just ask you on today, God, to do it for your people. Do it for your people. Whatever it is that they need. God, we pray a special protection over each and every one of your children. Oh God, do it right now. Do it right now. Angels encamped around about them. And Father, I pray a special prayer over our young people, our children. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, Deacon Kelly, play kids. Take a few guys, please. Amen. We pray, God, that our children, amen, that they will be kept safe. That our children, their minds will be kept safe. Their minds will be changed. Father, we pray against every plot and plan of the enemy that comes and tries to take our young people's minds. Father, we come against social media today. Father, we come against social media that's trying to infiltrate our children's minds. Father, I'm going to pray that every person that's on Snapchat that should not be on there, every pedophile that is using Snapchat to try to come against our young girls, Father, I'm going to pray that Snapchat won't work anymore. Instagram, any pedophile that's on their Instagram, God, I ask you to remove them right now. In the name of Jesus. Oh, God, do it. Facebook, whatever it is, God, they're trying to come in and take our children's minds. Do it right now, God. In the name of Jesus. Parents, listen. I got to say what God telling me to go say. When you get home, go through your child's phone today. I don't know why God telling me to do this, but go through Snapchat. Go through their text messages. Because there's some folks, amen, that don't mean well for your children. That's trying to come and take over their minds. But the devil is a liar. Go home, check through that. Listen, and many parents don't know, they got an app that's password protected that will hide your children's photos and text messages that they don't want you to see. Go through it. And I'm going to pray cell phones don't work until they're used for the right things. I feel the power of God. The internet is trying to take our children's minds. But we have to protect their eye gates, their ear gates. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Our children shall be protected. Don't let them sit and watch YouTube all day. People don't realize that a lot of these young kids that was dying was because YouTube people was on there teaching them how to hang themselves and teaching them how to commit suicide. Watch what these children are doing on their cell phones. Watch what they're doing on their cell phones. Watch them. But Satan, the Lord rebukes you on today. Our children shall be protected. Our children shall be protected. I know we have children spread all over the parking lot. Amen. But I need the adults just to point your hands in the direction towards some young people. And we're covering them today. We're covering them today. We're covering them today. In the name of Jesus. Protect our young people. Give them a hunger and a thirst after the word of God. Give them a hunger and a thirst after relationship with God. And we come against everything that the enemy's trying to do as he goes to and fro seeking whom he may devour. We come against him today. And Father, we pray for our seniors today. We pray a special prayer for our superintendent, God. Give him long life. Give him long life. Somebody agree with me. Give him long life.
give him long life in the name of Jesus. God, we pray for many blessings upon his life, every heart's desire. Do it right now, God. And we pray that he will not close his eyes for eternity until all his children are saved, until this church is filled, until his work is complete. Do it for him, God. Do it for him, God. In the mighty name of Jesus. God, strengthen him in his body. Strengthen him in his body right now. In the name of Jesus. Father, touch his wife, the evangelist, oh God. Lady Walker. Strengthen her in her body. We decree and declare long life. We decree and declare long life in the name of Jesus. Oh God, do it for your glory. And every person that's out in the parking lot, every person that's on live stream, oh God, do it for them, God. Whatever their heart's desires are, oh God, meet their needs in the mighty name of Jesus. And we thank you for it, and we bless you for it. In Jesus' mighty name we pray, amen. Come on, give God a hand clap of praise. Now listen, we have Cash App, Givelify, amen, for those that want to give electronically, amen, and for those, amen, that are out here, we want to encourage you to sow, we want to encourage you to sow, amen, we want to encourage you to sow. Listen, amen, listen, just want to be very transparent with you. Amen. To let you know how, amen, how things are going. Amen. We've had a building fund going, a building fund pledge. Amen. And due to the coronavirus coming and different funds and different things happening, amen, we kind of put it on hold. Amen. Some people, amen, definitely pushed and gave what they pledged even well before the pandemic came. Amen. And we thank you, amen. Brother Quentin, you can log everything off. Thank you for those that...